Blackstone Publishing presents Tiger Reef by John McKinna. This book is read by Jamie Renell. Dedicated to the wild places and the things that inhabit them, and to my wife, Teresa, who searches them out with me. I love you. Prologue. The tigress moved through the steaming Sumatran jungle as silently as a ghost. Her early morning patrol had taken her into higher country, up around the flank of a lushly forested mountain, and well above the gullies and wet meadows that were her usual haunts. It was not hunger that compelled her to leave familiar territory. She had been aware of the big male shadowing her for more than a week. Normally, she would have shunned him, instinctively respecting his territoriality and solitary nature. If she had had cubs, she would have avoided him at all costs, knowing that the great males of her species were savage, lone killers, capable of disposing of a litter of their own kind without hesitation. Tiger and tigress maintained separate lives most of the time, occasionally stalking the same silent jungle paths, and upon encountering each other, passing by with plenty of room to spare. But not all the time. The tigress was in heat. The age-old need to mate had turned her normal wariness of the male into interest. He possessed something she needed, and she would get it. But female instinct directed her to handle her powerful suitor carefully, with subtlety. She would wander through his territory in no particular hurry, and attract, entice, bewitch. She was beautiful and highly unusual. She was a white variant, a tigress with peridot green eyes and a white coat with blue-black stripes. Not an albino, but a natural, healthy variation within the species' gene pool. She was even more regal in appearance than her normally colored relatives. The big male, eyes glazed and nostrils filled with her rich scent, thought so. The tigress, well aware of him slinking through the undergrowth a dozen or so yards behind her, paused at a small opening in the trees. Far off, across the rich green expanse of treetops below, lay the indigo-blue reaches of the vast Pacific Ocean. She blinked her eyes and sniffed the wind. The aroma of salt drifted in and out on the breeze. It was a good spot. Settling down on her belly, her four legs resting sphinx-like on the ground before her, she casually turned her head and watched as the male tiger emerged from the cover of the trees. By Sumatran standards, he was huge. Over 500 pounds of muscle and sinew, draped in a glorious coat of fiery orange and black. Though the tigress was not small, he was almost twice her weight. As he neared her, she rose, tail twitching, and lowered her head. Peering up at him, she began to slink closer, pausing once to stretch languorously, then sidled around him. The language they shared was one of grunts, purrs, body movement, and eye contact. The tiger raised his great head high and looked sideways at her. Carefully, the tigress slunk provocatively around in front of him, keeping her head low, and brushed his nose with her tail. The tiger bared his fangs in a lethal grimace, and from his throat there came a long, low, rumbling growl. With exquisite care, the tigress placed herself on the ground in front of him and rolled over on her back, writhing a little. She reached up with one paw and brushed his whiskers. She rolled back onto her belly and lifted her tail aside, crouching. The big male, his eyes and brain fogged with testosterone, was on her in an instant, crushing her down with his weight. For a few brief moments, his powerful haunches thrust rhythmically, his canines bit into the loose hide of her neck, and the jungle reverberated with a deep, moaning growl. And then it was done. No sooner had the tigress felt the hot gush deep inside her loins than she abruptly lost interest in the procedure at hand, as did the male. When he was slow to move off her, she hurried him along with a vicious, open-clawed slap to the muzzle and a savage snarl. Too nonplussed to react, he sat back on his haunches and dumbly licked his stinging chops. Without a look back, The white tigress sauntered off into the trees, carrying deep within her the prize she had sought. Now, once again, she walked the shadows alone. The tigress was back in the low country, padding her way silently through the dense coastal jungle near the town of Bengkulu. She had come to know that the occasional goat could be taken from the rice paddies on the outskirts of the
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.